Now to a report on voter suppression you'll see for the first time exclusively right here on MSNBC. It's an in-depth look into how young voters of color in particular are having problems at the polls, major problems. One key finding, a lack of required identification kept young blacks from voting at nearly four times the rate of white youth, and Latino youth were disenfranchised at nearly twice the rate of whites. Joining me now for more on this, Matthew Siegel, co-founder of President and President of Our Time. That's Matthew. And Judith Brown Deanis, co-director of the Advancement Project. There she is. Thank you both for your time. Your organizations collaborated on this study. Matthew, I want to start with you. The report concluded that the millennial generation and young voters of color face a unique, quote, time tax at the polls. Can you explain that?
Well, we've talked a lot in the past about long lines at the polls. We've talked a lot about voter ID. But what we haven't necessarily considered is that there is a disproportionate burden on people's time in order to acquire the right form of ID, or in order to endure a 5, 6, 7 hour line to vote. And that, of course, takes people away from their job obligations, their class commitments, extracurriculars, and so forth. And that has economic implications in a big way.
Judith, I wanted to ask you to touch upon something that Matthew just said, which is the time required to get an ID. You know, there are people on the other side of this debate that say, well, what's the big deal? Why can't people just go out and get the ID that they need? What's the answer to that question?
Well, I mean, the big deal is that, first of all, it's important to understand that these laws were put in place to manipulate the rules around voting to disenfranchise particular groups, such as young people. So, for example, in the state of Wisconsin, 78% of young black men between 18 and 29 do not have voter ID. So they have to go and get their birth certificate and pay for those underlying documents and go get that particular kind of identification to then go get the ID. But, you know, at the end of the day, what we are doing is that we are making it harder for people to vote. We're making it harder for young people, for people of color, and we should especially be concerned that as we see the changing demographics of America, you know, there are 50,000 American Latinos that turn 18 every month. We should be making it easier for them. We should be having free, fair, and accessible elections, not making it harder for them to vote.
And Matt, back to this report, what are some of the other key findings?
Well, the other key findings really focus on the fact that this is part of a larger comprehensive problem. If you step back, you realize not only are we introducing, in light of the Voting Rights Act being dismantled essentially this summer, are we introducing more regressive laws that are doing away with same-day voter registration, they're doing away with early voting, they're making the types of ID you can show more and more restrictive and less accessible to people. They're not allocating enough machines to districts that have high minority and student populations so that there's longer wait. But if you even step back from there, this is in context with Citizens United, when money has been flooded into the system in an unprecedented way, where transparency is being dismantled, where money is now akin to speech so that only the rich people can be heard in our country. I think if you put this in conjunction with money in politics and with regressive laws being introduced that make it harder for people to vote, what we have found is that the next generation is going to have a harder time expressing their voice in a democracy, and that makes them opt out of the political process because they don't view it as an effective vehicle for change. And that is extremely damaging and dangerous.
And Judith, why is it that minority voters are so disproportionately affected, as we reported at the top of the segment?
Well, I mean, part of it is that we know that we looked at Virginia and Florida, for example, where the longest wait times were. You know, often we find that machines are not allocated in equal ways. We also know that so many of these laws that were passed recently, like North Carolina, for example, these laws were strategically and surgically crafted in order to disenfranchise particular groups.
I don't mean to cut you off, but in terms of the reasons why, I mean, we reported that blacks, young blacks are kept from voting nearly four times the rate of whites. So what are the reasons for those racial discrepancies?
Well, I mean, a lot of it is about the structural barriers that are put in place. It's not, you know, it is the fact that in particular places you may not have an allocation of machines that are adequate, you know, and we find that across the country, the kinds of laws, I mean, it really is about the structures that we're putting in place to make it particular for particular groups harder to vote. And so if you pass, and so for example, in North Carolina, where they passed that kind of kitchen sink of regressive laws, what they also did was that they took away pre-registration of 16 and 17-year-olds. Mm. They also moved, after they passed the law, they moved polling places off of college campuses in particular counties so that those folks would have to, you know, go 2 miles away. They'd have to walk to polling places where there's no sidewalks, for example, making it harder for those groups to vote. And mm. so we see this as actual, it's not just isolated incidents, but we're making it harder for young people to vote. We know that we have a more racially diverse young electorate, and unfortunately, state legislatures are seeing it in their best interests for partisan gain to pass these laws to make it harder for them.
All right, Judith and Matt, thank you both for your time, and thank you for bringing this report to us first. We appreciate it.